As I said before, I am the pure Ronald by name, and spelling is my favorite game. But I do not spell words letter for letter. Oh no, my method is 1,000 times better. You see, every word for me is a story. And sometimes I even use allegory. And according to the situation from time to time, I will shorten it into pleasant rhyme. This is one that you might know. As the child said, chicken in the car and the car cargo. That's the way you spell Chicago. Or I might say, a jar in your hand and you play a pan. That's the way you spell Japan. Or I know a guy like my sister Anna. That's the way you spell Guyana. But I could spell words plenty longer than that if only you would challenge my fact. That is why when I travel near or far, I am considered a cultural philosopher. You hear that big word philosopher? You think you would spell it by chance? But you have to spell it in local parlance. And remember, the Perugonard is spelling story. So listen carefully to my story. Suppose you is a racehorse fan and just follow every horse race in the land. But you're tired of losing your money badly, so you decide to invest it very wisely. And since you want to be your own true boss, you decide to buy your own racehorse. And to practice what you will say at the cashier still, you decide to name your racehorse Phil. Now Phil start to enter race, but you know how them racehorse races best? All them other horses running so fast that your poor horse Phil only coming out last. Well, you're not dismayed, so you try again. But time after time, it is all in vain. Try as you want to make it run fast, they're still coming out last. Now you're feeling down and really depressed, and your body and soul in extreme distress. So to cool the brain and to clearly think, you decide to go by the bar for a drink. But on your way there, you bounce up your partner Bill, and he decide to ask you about your racehorse Phil. Now you know what you bet, Phil never win a single race yet. So when he asks you, how Phil doing partner, you have to tell him, boy, Phil lost so far. Now this spelling is easy to see. So spell it all together. And I tell you, I just travel near and far. And last year, I find myself in North America. Hartford, Connecticut to be exact. And a Yankee fella decided to challenge my fact. He said, Pearl, let's see what you got. I wonder if you can spell Connecticut. I say, I will spell Connecticut for you, as only the Pearl Renard can do. Connecticut. Now, in the village where there's usually lime, every now and then they just have a little crime. That is because they have a con man living in the region. And knowing how we like to nickname man, everybody just call him con. I also have a neighbor named Teresa Fort, and we just call she T for short. Now the other day, con find himself by neighbor T because he wanted to thief she money. But it so happened that T was in the kitchen because she was cooking something, and she had a long kitchen knife in she hand, and she fired some chop at the thiefing man and catch him right here on the spot. And it's called Connecticut. Now, when I spell that, they had another fella standing up right there by this stage, and he getting on in a rage, giving me pressure. So I said, what is your problem, partner? He said, Piero, and you is a Caribbean man? I said, yes, I is a born and bred Trinbegonian. He said, well, why are you spelling things from foreign land? I said, where you from, partner? He said, I from Jamaica. You could spell Jamaica? I said, okay, you will help me, partner. Now, this was a Rasta fella, and he was right near the stage with his little daughter. So I look at the girl and said, what a pretty little girl. You could see God make her. He said, no, brother man, it's Jamaica. Now, I hope you have enjoyed this Pearl Renard show. Thank you. Thank you very much.